Hello everybody, let us continue lesson number 8, wind, storms and cyclones of standard 7, subject science. Today's topic is topic number 8.4. Wind currents are generated due to uneven heating on the earth. We know that children, on the earth temperature is not same in all the places. For example, near to the equator the temperature is high, whereas near to the north pole and south pole the temperature is low temperature. But how it generate? So two types of wind currents are generated. The first one is uneven heating between the equator and the poles. The first one, how do wind currents are generated? It is because of uneven heating between equator and the poles. But how it take place? Let us understand with this given figure. Here it is earth globe figure I have drawn. You know that at the 0 degree latitude it is equator, and near to the equator the sun rays falls straight, and so the land heat up faster, and we can say that here it is the more heat is there. So when air gets heat up, we know that it moves towards up, that means it rise up, and when the air rise up, the space left behind it will take by the comparatively cool air. So when from the places near to the equator air rise up, this left space will be taken from the winds which blow from 30 degree north latitude or 30 degree south latitudes. So here the air will rise up, and this air will take place of it. Same way from the south, 30 degree south, the air will blow towards 0 degree. So one wind current will generate. Now here it is when air rise up, so it start to cool down again. When it cool down, it move towards either 30 degree north or 30 degree south, means either of the side the wind current will flow, and from here it will start to blow towards 60 degree. So from here it will rise up and move towards 30 to 60 degree, and this way the current will blow like this. Here again the temperature is comparatively higher than the pole. The pole temperature is extreme cold temperature, and here it is the temperature is high. So here again the current will be generated, that means the air which is of high temperature will move up, and this current will blow, that means from north to 60 degree again the current will flow. Same way here, from south to 60 degree south the current will blow. So this way, from equator to north pole, from equator to south pole, currents will be generated. So this way, because of uneven heating of the on the earth, the wind currents will flow or generate. I think it is clear to you. Now the second one is uneven heating of land and water. This we have learned in previous chapter, that is heat chapter, that means sea breeze and land breeze. We know that sea breeze blows when during the daytime, and land breeze flows during the night time. So something like that. That means land heats up faster, and also it gets cool more frequently, means quickly compared to sea. So here it is, during the summer, winds to flow from the oceans towards the land. That means during the summer, land heat up faster, and so the air on the land will heat up and rise up, and that place will be taken from by the winds blowing from ocean. But when wind blow from ocean, it carries water droplets with it, and so that monsoon winds generate, and monsoon winds are the reason to carry a rain. On the other side, during the ocean. That means during the winter, sea water is comparatively higher temperature. So wind flow from land to sea. But here, when monsoon winds come, the monsoon winds carry water and it rains. So monsoon winds brings water and it brings rain. But all the time, mostly we can say that when monsoon comes, everywhere it spreads happiness for all the living and not living things. But always, monsoon is not a happy thing. Sometimes it brings some disasters with it. For example, flood or cyclone or tornado like that. So here also we are going to discuss about all these things. For now, that's it. For now, thank you.